To get started with exercise 1, we can select the Pi Vision shortcut on the desktop. This will open up a Google Chrome browser and connect us to our Pi Vision page. From here, we can see we already have 3 displays created: Wind Farm Turbine Overview, Wind Farm Turbine Detail, and Wind Farm Overview. Those could be thought of as references, and to start exercise 1, we can create a new display. To get started with this exercise, we want to have a way to navigate between our AF hierarchy through an on-screen symbol. To do that, we are going to create 3 collections that represent the 3 levels of our AF hierarchy: the region, the farm, and the turbine. The reason having an on-screen navigation symbol is useful is on mobile devices, you won't have access to the asset drop-down box, so this provides a way to change context on those devices. Additionally, when swapping through different levels of AF hierarchies, it's a little easier to visualize having an on-screen navigation symbol that shows each level separately, so that way you can better see what you're changing. Let's get started by making the region collection. To do that, we can drill into the Wind Farm database and select one of our regions. I'll pick Northeast. From there, we can find the region name attribute and select a value symbol from our symbol selector, then drag that attribute onto the display pane to create it. Now we can format this value symbol to only show the Northeast value. We don't really need to show the label or the timestamp here. To do that, we can right-click on the symbol and select Format Value. Then expand the Visibility section and uncheck Label, Unit, and Timestamp. We can also increase the font size of the symbol to make it stand out a little bit more. Once completed, we can click back into the display pane to close the configuration. Now, we just need to convert this value symbol to a collection to show the other region as well. To do that, we can right-click on the value symbol and hit Convert to Collection. What this will do is search for related assets based on the search route defined in the collection criteria. The default route in this case is already showing both regions, Northeast and Sirocco, so we don't have to make any changes. Instead, let's just format this collection so it only shows one region at a time. Now, let's make the next collection that will be used for the farm level. To do that, we can drill into the Northeast region and select one of our farms. I'll select New York. Again, we can see there's a farm name attribute, which we can drag onto the display to create. Again, we can format this to just show the value and not show the label or timestamp. And increase the font size to match the region. Now again, we can convert this to a collection, just as before. And we can see this time it's showing us the New York and Philadelphia regions. That makes sense because our search route is defined as the Northeast region, so it's only going to be showing us farms that are within the Northeast region. This is what we want, so again, we can format this to only show one farm at a time. Finally, we can make the last collection for the turbine. To do that, we can drill into our farm and select a turbine. I'll select NY001. Now we can select the turbine name attribute and drag it onto the display. We can again format this, just as we did before. And again, we can convert this to a collection. Notice the default search route is the Northeast New York. So this will only be showing us turbines that are within the New York farm. This is what we would like. So again, we can just format this as before. Now, let's bring on some other attributes to actually show the data that would be interesting for our clients to see. From the exercise, we can see that they're interested in the active power, apparent power, and lifetime production attributes. Let's go ahead and make a trend to show both the active power and the apparent power. To quickly do that, we can multi-select both attributes by holding in either the Control or Shift key on our keyboard. Then we need to ensure the trend is selected from our symbol selector, and we can drag them onto the display. For the lifetime production attribute, let's make that a horizontal gauge and place that on the bottom. I'll select the lifetime production hourly attribute. And now I need to ensure my horizontal gauge symbol is selected from the symbol selector. And I'll create that symbol. Now let's also put in at the top another turbine name attribute just to indicate which turbine we are on. And we'll do that as a value symbol. And we can again format that to only show the value. Okay, so now we would like to have a way to select other regions, other farms, and other turbines, and have this display update to reflect our selection. To do that, we will need to configure navigation links on each of these collections and change the context of the current display with them. Let's start with the region collection. To add a navigation link, we can right-click on this collection and hit Modify Collection. This will show us the original attribute that we pulled in, or the original symbol that we pulled in to create the collection. From here, we can right-click on that and hit Add Navigation Link. And then Add Navigation Link pane, we have two options for our action. We can open a hyperlink to another page, or we can change the context of the current display. We want to change the context of the current display. Now we have two more options, Use Current Asset or Use Current Asset as Root. Since we're going to be changing the region level of our hierarchy, we want to be selecting the Use Current Asset as Root. Now we can select Exit Modify Mode to get back to our display. In the event you've exited Build Mode, you can just reselect the Build Mode icon. Now we can repeat this process for both the farm collection and the turbine collection. Now, let's try changing the region to the Sirocco region. Once we do that, we notice we see no data on our display, but our farm collection is updated to show the farms in the Sirocco region. Let's select one of them. Now we see the turbines have populated for that farm. Let's select one of them. And now we can see our display is updated to show information from the turbine RB003. You can now go ahead and format your display to make it look a little nicer. We could do some things like line up these collections, and potentially add some labels to give it more context. The copy and paste function can be used to quickly duplicate Once you have finished with your display, you can save this as Wind Farm Turbine Overview and then your initials. Now, we can go and answer the questions. The first question asks, what is the hourly lifetime production for turbine GE004? That turbine is within the Soraka region. The hourly lifetime production looks to be 1,835.7 kilowatt hours. The next question is, what is the difference in active power and apparent power for turbine RB009? In this case, the active power is around 2700 kilowatts, and the apparent power is around 2800 kilowatts. So I would say the difference here looks to be a little over 100 kilowatts. Once finished with the questions, we can save any changes we might have made, and then move on to the next exercise.